Hi and welcome everybody. In this video I want to work on a few of your shots again, since I got a few really cool images since I uploaded the last one. And by the way, if you want me to edit your image for the next video, then just write me a DM on Instagram. Now in this video I will be editing 5 different images, so of course it will be a little bit longer. And at this point I really want to thank you for sending me those images. It really was a ton of fun working on them. But now let's start with the first image. And here we have a beautiful seascape image with a nice little path leading up to a lighthouse. And this is actually my very first lighthouse image I'm editing, so I'm super excited for this one. I think you can already guess what I want to do here. I want to turn this into a really, really colorful sunset shot with lots of warm color tones. So, but first, let's start by activating the lens corrections. And you can see this will also make the shot way brighter already. Then for the basic adjustments, for the profile, I'm going with Adobe Landscape just to give the picture some more base saturation. I'm not touching the white balance globally because I think this looks pretty awesome, but let's first work on the global adjustments. I think I want to reduce the highlights a little bit. Also, let's add some contrast right away. And according to the histogram, we do have some room to the right, so let's increase the whites. Okay, then let's add a little bit of texture, just to make the foreground a bit more interesting. I'm not going to add clarity globally, maybe later with the local adjustments, but for now let's also add some vibrance. Okay, then it's time for the local adjustments. Let me create a gradiated filter for the sky part. And I want to use this one mainly to darken the sky a little bit by dropping the exposure. And I could also add some clarity. And I think it's starting to produce a little bit of noise up there, so let's also apply some noise reduction. Okay. Then let's create a radial filter on the right border of the image. And reset all those settings real quick. Now here I want to change the colors a bit, and therefore I'm using the temperature setting. And I just want to make everything a bit warmer, maybe add some tint. And I can also apply noise reduction again. Okay. Let's apply another gradiated filter for the foreground. And again, reset the settings first. Here I want to drop the exposure just a little bit. Okay. And then let's apply some more clarity to those rocks on the shore. Here I'm just creating a new radial filter and place it roughly above those rocks. And then let's add some clarity here. Maybe also some texture. Okay, this does look pretty neat already. And let's do some color grading. I think I can get rid of the aqua color tones. And there seem to be some green tones I don't want, so I'm dropping the saturation as well. Let's see, I want to increase the orange tones, of course. And maybe drop the yellow ones a little bit. And I can also increase the blue tones. Alright, next the split toning. Of course, I'm going with the nice warm color tone for the highlights. And this works just lovely. Then for the shadows, I'm choosing a cold color tone. Alright. Then next, let's apply some sharpening. And then let's open the image to finish it in Photoshop. Okay, I think the shot is a bit uneven, so I'm simply using the crop tool by pressing C, and then I'm choosing that straighten icon on top of it. and just drag a line over the surface of the water. Okay. Next, I want to check the Nick collection for some nice effects. And first I want to apply the polarization filter. And let's increase the strength a bit. Okay. Then let's check the Nick collection one more time. And I actually think I could make this image a little bit colder. And therefore I'm simply using the brilliance filter and I'm dropping the warmth. Then let's play around with the saturation a bit. Okay. Then I want to make a few spots brighter throughout the image. So I'm creating a new layer and change the blending mode to soft light this time. Actually, no, I'm going with overlay. And I'm picking a white color, select the brush tool and also drop the opacity of the brush. And then let's paint over a few spots here. Okay, maybe let's check the Nick collection one more time. And let's apply the classical soft focus filter with the first diffusion method. And this works pretty cool on this shot. Of course, we need to mask out a few areas right here. I don't want the foreground to be blurry. Instead, it has to be sharp, so I'm just using a black brush and mask out all those rocks in the foreground. Okay, and that is it for editing this lighthouse seascape image. Alright then, let's work on another sunset shot. And I really love the framing of this image. So I think we can do quite a few nice things here. But first let's check the lens corrections real quick. Then let's see, for the profile I'm going with Adobe Standard since Adobe Landscape does boost the saturation too much in my opinion. For the white balance we could go with something really warm like cloudy. Let's actually tone it down a bit and go with daylight so it isn't too warm. Then next let's work on the exposure balancing. I could carefully reduce the highlights a little bit, but I won't be able to restore anything around the sun area, of course, but that's also not a big deal if this area is overexposed. I could of course increase the shadows quite a bit, but that would look kind of strange to me, so I'm also only applying some subtle change here. Then let's see, maybe some contrast right away. Okay, and then I already want to jump into the local adjustments. Of course, we have a really, really good foreground here, and I want to work on that by creating a gradiated filter somewhere around here. Then I want to work on the structure of those rocks by increasing the clarity, and you can see this will also make the rocks a bit brighter. And let's also apply some texture. Alright, nice. Maybe let's also add some temperature. Just a bit. Okay. Then let's create a radial filter for the area around the sun. Let's see, I want to apply a little bit of glow here, so I'm increasing the blacks. And the glow does look kind of weird since it doesn't have the same color as the sun. So let's pick a color here. And let's go with a nice warm color tone. And this will help a little bit. Now before I go on with the color grading, I think I might want to try something else by applying a big gradiated filter over the whole image like this. Let's reset the settings real quick. Then I'm applying a luminance range mask. And I only want to affect the darker colors with this gradiated filter. So I'm going to limit the luminance range to something like this. And now I just want to brighten up the image a little bit without affecting the highlights. So let's increase the whites. Yeah, that looks beautiful. Let's further bring down the range here. Alright. Let's see, maybe we can also add some clarity and even some exposure. Okay, then let's go to the HSL tab for a bit of color grading. I actually want to increase the blue saturation, reduce the yellow ones, and maybe let's also increase the orange tones a bit. Okay, and then of course the split toning, which should work pretty good on this shot. First, I'm choosing a warm hue for the highlights. And let's increase the saturation. Okay, and for the shadows, of course, I'm going with the cold tone. And then finally, the sharpening. Okay. Now to finish this image, first I want to check the Nick collection for some cool effects. And first I want to go with the sunlight filter, which will apply this nice glow effect. Here I'm playing around with the light temperature and the light strength a bit. Alright. Of course, I don't want to have the effect over the foreground, so I'm creating a layer mask on the glow layer. And I'm simply brushing out the foreground. And let's also maybe drop the opacity a bit. Okay, then next I want to have some more contrast in the foreground. So I'm going to apply a curves adjustment layer and I'm simply using an S-curve. Okay, not that much of an S-curve anymore, but it does its job. Next I'm inverting the layer mask and use a white brush to paint back in the contrast for the foreground. Alright, this looks pretty cool. And maybe let's do some dodging and burning by creating another new layer and changing the blending mode to overlay. Then let's grab a bright white color and change the opacity of the brush again. And let's work on the foreground a little bit more. Actually, I think I'm getting rid of the dodging and burning layer because I don't like the look. I think there just isn't that much to do for this shot since it's such a great base image. Depending on how you like your shots, you can of course make it brighter or darker. I prefer my shots a little bit on the darker side, so I'm not going overboard with the brightness here. And at this point I will stop the editing for this amazing photo. Next up we have the cool foggy autumn image, on which I want to apply a little bit of a darker mood. So again, let's first check the lens corrections. And for the profile, I'm going with Adobe Standard, since I don't think any more base saturation will help in this image. For the white balance, I simply want to drop the temperature to give everything a colder look. Then maybe let's drop the exposure. And add some whites and reduce the blacks a bit. Maybe let's also add some contrast. And since this is a foggy image, for those kind of photos, I like to drop the texture just to give everything a softer look. And then let's work on the foreground for a little bit. I'm creating a gradiated filter here. And since I want to make this reflection in the water a bit clearer, I'm increasing the clarity. And maybe let's also add some texture. Then I think I want to darken the upper part of the image by creating another gradiated filter and dropping the exposure slightly. Okay. Now let's create a radial filter for this grass in the foreground. And to make this area more interesting, I'm simply increasing the clarity. And as you can see, this will bring a bit more attention to that grass in the foreground. Alright. The image is still a bit dark, so I'm increasing the whites without overexposing anything. Then maybe let's create another radial filter for the woodland area in the back. Something like this maybe. And again, I want to increase the clarity. Looks good to me. Then let's do some color grading. I really don't like those green color tones in the foreground, so I'm going to the hue tab and I'm dropping the greens all the way down, which will make them more yellow. And then I'm also dropping the yellow tones, and I'm getting this nice orange autumn-like tone in the foreground. Then let's boost the yellow saturation to even increase that. And maybe let's also increase the luminance a bit to make it brighter. And then let's drop the aqua saturation, since we have a lot of those tones in the tree in the foreground. And I think that just looks weird. Let's see, maybe we can also drop the blue saturation a bit. Okay. Then for the split toning, I'm not touching the highlights, but I want to apply cold color tone to the shadows. And we could even go to the calibration tab and boost the blue primary saturation a bit more. Okay, but I think that's it for the raw adjustments. Actually, I think there won't be much left to do in Photoshop, since it's already a really cool image. Let's clean it up a little bit by using the spot healing brush. Okay, then maybe there are some nice Nick Collection effects to apply on this image. And to further work on this dreamy, foggy look, I'm applying the classical soft focus filter. And here I'm going with the third soft focus method. That means it's a bit darker than the others. Alright, and of course I don't want to have this effect over the whole image. I mainly want to have it on the top. So I'm creating a layer mask and I'm masking out the foreground. And at this point I'm stopping the editing for this shot, since I'm quite satisfied with the look of it. Then another great autumn shot with a really cool framing here. And on this shot, I think I'd like to apply some heavier editing. So let's start by activating the lens corrections. Then let's see, I think I'm going with Adobe Landscape for a more saturated base image. Then for the white balance, I might want to increase the temperature just slightly. And right away, drop the highlights a bit. And increase the shadows. And this way, lose a bit of contrast, which isn't too bad for a foggy image like this one. Then let's increase the whites. Okay, and of course, since it's a hazy image, I'm dropping the texture to give everything a smoother look. Now, I could also play around with the vibrance and saturation. And then let's create a gradiated filter for the foreground. I kind of want to create a gradient from dark to bright from, so let's drop the exposure carefully. And then I want to use a radial filter on the top. And let's see, maybe increase the blacks to add some glow effect there. And decrease clarity and texture. Okay, I think I want to boost the contrast some more. But that's it for the basic adjustments. Then let's do some color grading. Again, I don't like the green tone of the leaves, so I'm dropping the green hue. And let's also drop the yellow hue a bit. Then boost the saturation of the yellow tones. Then I'm removing the saturation of the green tones. Now I want to apply a little bit of split toning by going for a cold color tone for the shadows. Okay, and of course I'm sharpening the image. Then let's see what we can do in Photoshop to finish the editing. First, again, I want to get rid of a few things, so I'm using the spot healing brush again. Okay, and then let's see what we can apply with the Nick Collection. Now I really like those autumn colored leaves, but I think they are going under with all the stuff going on in this image. So I can change that by using the foliage filter, and you can see this will boost the colors quite a bit. Now, since I don't want to have green color tones in there, I'm going with the first method. And let's boost that quite a bit to have some nice color contrast going on in that image. Okay. Now I might want to mask out a few areas here, like the foreground. So I'm creating a layer mask on that foliage layer. And I'm simply painting over the foreground here. Maybe let's drop the opacity just a little bit. Okay. Then let's check the Nick collection once more. And I further want to work on the leaves. I actually want to make them more orange or yellow-like. So this time I'm using the Indian Summer filter, and you can see this really does change the leaves. Now, of course, I don't want to go over the top with this. So I think I'm going with the last method here. Let's maybe increase the foliage. It does look quite heavy, but I actually like it. So let's just apply it. Okay, I think that looks awesome. I still want to apply a layer mask and again mask out the foreground here. And now one last thing I'd like to do is to again apply some dreamy effect using the Nick Collection plugin. And now let's apply the classical soft focus filter again with the third soft focus method. And again, let's create a layer mask real quick. And here I'm brushing out the foreground and the darker areas on the right side. Then I'm brushing along the tree. Alright, and let's also decrease the opacity. Alright, and that's it for this autumn image. Here we also have a HDR image, which I'm going to edit in Lightroom for the basic raw adjustments, just so I can merge the HDR. So before I'm going to merge it, I first want to check the lens corrections and apply those on all the three bracketed shots. And then let's merge the HDR by selecting the three shots and go to Photo Merge HDR. And once the preview has loaded, just hit the merge button. And now we can start working on this awesome landscape image. So let's start by changing the profile to Adobe Standard. And let's adjust the white balance a bit. I think I'm going with daylight, since this has this nice neutral color tone. But now let's fix the overexposure by dropping the highlights first. Alright, looks good. I don't need to adjust the shadows, because right now there aren't any underexposed areas. So let's see, I want to increase the clarity a little bit. And I also want to add some vibrance and saturation. But then I already want to start with the local adjustments. So let's apply a gradiated filter for the foreground. And here I want to have some more clarity. Okay. And then let's apply a radial filter for the sky part. Invert it. And here I want to increase the blacks to create some fake glow. And I can even duplicate this one and make it a little bit smaller. Okay, I think I want to crop the image and make it a little bit more panoramic. I think something like this would look pretty cool. Then let's apply another radial filter for the sky. And then drop the texture just to make it a bit smoother up there. Okay, then let's do a little bit of color grading. For this shot, I actually want to push the green tones, but also get rid of the yellow ones. And maybe push the orange ones as well. Let's check the hue tab real quick. I think I'm also dropping the green hue because I like this warmer color much better. Okay. I think I also want to drop the blue saturation and then work on the split toning. This time for the highlights, I'm going with a warm color tone, but with a rather low saturation. And for the shadows, I'm going with a cold color tone. Then let's see, I think a little bit of vignetting would also look quite good on this shot. And let's play around in the calibration tab as well. First I want to drop the blue primary hue. And I think that's it for the calibration tab. Now let's also sharpen the image. And then let's open it in Photoshop to finish the editing. Okay, and first I want to apply some more local glow. So I'm creating a new layer and switch the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool, set the foreground color to white, and drop the brush opacity to around 10%. And then I'm painting in a little bit of glow. I think I can also improve those sun rays, which are now almost invisible, but here I need to drop the opacity of the brush even further. I think I need to mask them out a little bit. Something like this looks pretty decent, I guess. So let's merge those two layers. And then of course check the Nick collection for some cool effects. And in this case I want to go with the Indian summer filter, because I think the orange tones are working well together with the blue color tones of the upper part of the image. Of course I'm not going with a too heavy foliage method, but I think this one would look pretty cool. Okay. And last I want to play around a little bit with the brightness and contrast adjustment layer. And here I'm decreasing the brightness and maybe add some contrast. And then I'm going to use its layer mask with a black brush and paint in some brighter spots, like in the center part. And of course in the upper part where the light is coming through, as well as in the foreground. Okay, and that's it for this HDR image. Alright, and that's it for this video. I hope this was something different from the usual quick edit video and you found this interesting and helpful. Again, if you want me to edit your image in a video like this, then just contact me on Instagram. And thank you very much for watching this video.